recognize the senator from the 14th.
Thank you, Mr. President. I rise today specifically because I am a Democrat, and I served under Speaker Ralston for 4 years in the House. And I want to join with the majority today in expressing my appreciation for how he served. I've spoken from this well before about the kind of heartburn you get when you're in the minority in this General Assembly, both houses, House and Senate to some degree. And you learn quickly you don't get what you want all the time. And I know there are a lot of speakers today, and I won't be super long-winded, but what I will say is that there was a measure of caring about the institution of the General Assembly and the House that Speaker Ralston held dear that made it worth it for everybody to serve, including Democrats, even when you didn't get what you wanted. And there was a way that he communicated respect and dignity in the institution that when we talk about hyperpolarization, when we talk about the ways that partisanship is threatening the United States, what he carried and held dear and communicated to members of both of his party and the opposition was the antidote to that. And it had such a resounding and lasting effect on so many of us that you see, even now, the Ralston legacy hard at work in the House, and you see it in the inspiration that members of both parties still bring to serve, including me. And I'm proud to be part of that legacy. And if there's any ambiguity about how many of us Democrats feel in the House and in this body, I just wanted to make it 100% clear that this is a bipartisan resolution for a great man. Thank you, Mr. President. I yield the floor.
Recognize the senator from the 18th.